The chosen ones are protected by the Spirit. Who are the chosen ones? They are those who came to this earth with a mission. They are those whose soul contract appears extremely difficult most times. But they are strong enough to pursue their intended mission in life. Welcome to my channel, the Paranormal Life Channel. Don't forget to click like as it enables the algorithm to send the clip to a wider audience. The term chosen one is merely a description of those souls coming into this world to help humanity. These people are not influenced by money or worldly pleasures. In fact, they feel uncomfortable with worldly temporary pleasures and the deceptive allure of the world. Be careful who you try to harm. It might just be one of God's chosen ones. If you try to hurt them, it will backfire on you. In fact, everything you do evil against such a person will backfire and hit you very hard negatively in a bad way. If you steal from them, you will slowly start to lose everything. If you talk bad about them, it will come back to you and suddenly most will talk bad about you. If you try and murder them, your own beloved people in your circle will suddenly lose their lives. In fact, everything dear to you will suddenly die, be it your dog you love so much or the plants you care so much. These chosen people of God walk not alone. They are constantly surrounded by highly evolved spirit guides and guardian angels who make direct contact with them. Do not harm or try and harm these people. Their prayers get answered from above. Chosen ones have different missions. They have been chosen before birth, before coming into this physical world. Some of them become medical doctors. Some are peacemakers, others are writers, teachers, or just an ordinary person, and even someone who is homeless. The ordinary normal person won't be able to endure what they are often faced with in life. The chosen people can be recognized. They do not violate other people, they walk away from arguments. They do not indulge in much worldly talk. They feel pain at the suffering of others. They do not harm others, not even animals, insects, or even plants. You will also recognize them by the invisible aura or etheric, electric field surrounding them. We are presently living in the most materialistic and profane, ungodly time of the planet. It is the law of the universe, for every evil rising, good rises to meet it. If evil people overcome good people, the will collapse. But there is not enough darkness to obliterate the faintest light. Many people are walking among you, who are on a contrary mission of darkness. These are those who get extreme delight in harming others. You can recognize them. I have a name for them. They are the great pretender. He or she will smile in your face while stabbing you in your back. It's the nature of evil. When an evil person does an evil deed, they get extreme happiness and they become delighted stealing your stuff. Then they lie, it's not them, they never stole anything. They actually think nothing of you. I'm a journalist and have done many newspaper articles of how the wife poisons the husband just to get her bans on his life policy. Murders most times have no remorse. Even people of religion tend to ask pardon to those they harmed before they die, not because they feel ashamed and sorry about it, it's basically because they fear going to hell. There are people walking in the road who do not have souls, but they are demons in human bodies who are ready to harm you in any which way.